back to Art Class with Miss Chris. This week, our school is celebrating Operation Gratitude. And I thought it would be really fun for our art program to celebrate a first responder. We're going to celebrate firefighters today. Now, when I say Operation Gratitude, what this is a organization that is grateful and thankful to military and first responders for all the things they do for us and how they protect us. And in the past, our school has written letters of thanks and sent them. And it's just a really great way for people to know that they're appreciated. So with all the fires that have happened through the last few years in California, I have always thought about the firefighters and all the things that they do to help keep our community safe. So today we're going to draw a fire engine, a complete truck. All right, to start this drawing, we're going to create a big rectangle shape, and this is going to be the body of our fire truck. All right, so to do this, I'm going to come right here. And oh, I should let you know what you need to gather, I'm sorry, before we get started. You will need a pencil, a black Sharpie. If you don't have a black Sharpie, don't worry about it. It's just a marker, a red marker. I'm using Sharpie. I really like the Sharpie brand. And an orange marker. This will be for some accents on cones and things on our fire truck. And a yellow marker. Now I found this, I was looking today and I found this. This is a highlighter. So this will be a very bright stripe that goes through my fire truck today. You will need a eraser. All right, let's get started. This is gonna take a little bit, so I wanna get to it right away. Here we go. All right, we need a rectangle. So I'm gonna just come up here, and I don't want you to draw super dark because we are gonna erase. But this is gonna be a pretty long rectangle, okay? Because there's a lot to a fire truck. Hoses and ladders and all kinds of stuff. I'm gonna come down here, about that far. I'm gonna come down here about that far. It's gonna look like a big brick. And this brick is gonna get very, very cool. All right, so there's our beginning. So after we create this long rectangle, I'm gonna start at the front of the fire truck. So I'm gonna come right here at the top and I'm gonna curve down, all the way down. And then right at the bottom, this is gonna be a bumper. So I'm gonna bulge out a little bit and connect that. See how I did that? At this point, I'm going to erase that line. I just don't need it anymore. All right, so I like to just take things step by step and piece by piece when I'm drawing something like this. So I'm gonna kind of start in the front and work myself to the back of the fire truck, adjusting as I need it. So I'm gonna start with the front windshield. Okay, so we're gonna come right here. See how I bulged out right here? So right here, we're gonna come across and we're gonna create a windshield in this fire truck. And I'm looking at this, I don't think I'm giving enough space here for all the details I wanna put. I'm gonna make my windshield just a little bit smaller, just so I have enough space for all the fun stuff. Okay, so there's my windshield. And I did make it a little smaller because there's a lot going on down here. On the top right here, I'm gonna create a light. This is one of those lights when you see when fire trucks are going down the street and these things are blinking red really fast because there's an emergency. So I'm gonna create this red light right here. All right, we'll make that red later. All right, let's work ourselves down. We're gonna come down here and we're going to create we're going to come down to the bumper and we're going to create a line that goes about that far. Okay. We're just starting it. Now we're going to come next to that first windshield and we're going to create the door of our fire truck. So I'm going to come here and I'm going to create another window. Lots of windows, right? This is where the firefighters sit as they go off to their emergency situations. I know lots of firefighters that live in my neighborhood and my community, and they are great people. So helpful and wonderful. All right, so now below this windshield, I'm gonna put right here, it's kind of like a handle. It's like a little side mirror. It's gonna come through here. It's gonna be kind of like that. And with a little loop on the end, it's gonna be like a mirror so the firefighter can see back here. Okay, now we're gonna create a door. So I'm gonna make a line that goes between those two windows, and it's gonna come down to our bumper, and then it's going to run across. And we're gonna stop it right here. We're gonna start our next window. So our next window is actually a door that opens, and it's a smaller window. So right here, I'm gonna give a little space. Right here, I'm gonna create a smaller window. Okay, and while we're at the windows, let's just make our back window. Maybe in this window, you wanna put a dog, a fire dog. He lives in the firehouse. He goes out with the guys and helps them. Whatever, I'm just making stuff up. That'd be fun. Okay, so then we have our first 1, 2, 3, 4 windows of our fire truck. Now next to this window, we're gonna make a line that goes down. Straight down. Okay, it's gonna kind of cut off because this section that we're gonna do next is where a lot of equipment is. And then the back section of our fire truck is gonna be where like our ladder and some of our hoses are. So let's focus on this next. Let's stick with the front part with our windows. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a wheel. I'm gonna erase this a little bit. Okay, so I'm gonna make a line that goes down right here. Take this line right here, sorry. I hope I'm not being too confusing. And let's just take that line all the way across. See how I did that? All the way across, okay. So the next step is creating this first door. So I'm gonna come close to that window, second window. I'm gonna come down, and right when I hit that, about where that bumper would be, I'm going to curve out, okay? Then I'm gonna take that curve. This is gonna be my wheel well. I'm gonna go across. These fire trucks have big wheels, okay? And I'm going to go across here, underneath, and I'm just gonna make a line that mimics it. See how I did that? And then we can close this off and close this off. So our wheel's gonna go down here. Here's our bumper area, remember? I'm just gonna make a line that goes, just make sure the line goes across here. Down here at the bumper, here's another red light, important light. Lots of red blinking lights, right? All right, in here is our wheel. So I'm gonna come around and I'm gonna make a circle. So part of the wheel may be up in this area, so I'm just gonna use that curve to help me make that wheel. All right, there it is. And then I'm gonna make a circle inside. My hubcap. Okay. Make a circle inside. And then I'm gonna make little circles around. These are bolts holding that hubcap to my wheel. All righty, so there we go. I'm gonna come across here. Now I'm gonna take this line now through here and to here. All right, we have a few more details in the first part of our fire truck. So I would like to come between the little window and this back window. And I'm going to take a line down and another line next to it. These are doors. And let's put little door handles on. Door handle, and back here, the door handle. So I have the first part of my fire truck. I know this is a lot, but you can do it. All right, so the front of my fire engine, let's create a few more lights. I'm gonna go one light, two light, and three lights. So I have three lights, a light on the top, a light on the side, door handles, some doors, our tire. And then one thing that fire trucks, they're usually red, right? They do have a bright yellow streak that goes through them. So we're gonna work on that right now. This is when I'm gonna use my highlighter to make this. So right, so you see this middle light right here? We're gonna take a line and we're gonna go through all the way through to about here, okay? And then I'm gonna come and I'm gonna make another line underneath it, all the way through to about here. Now this line, once I get to here, we're gonna take this part and we're gonna make it go towards there and towards there. This is gonna be all bright yellow. And I'm gonna show you how to color this in at the end of class. I wanna name my engine. So I'm gonna make kind of like a circle right here. And I'm gonna put a number in it. Now you can put any number you want. I'm gonna write the word engine right there. You don't have to do that, but you could put your age, you could put your favorite sports player's number, whatever you'd like. I'm gonna name my fire engine number 35 because that is my son's favorite number. Puts on all his jerseys, so that's for him. Okay, so number 35. And now we're gonna move on. So now we're gonna go into a section that's right here, okay? This section carries a lot of equipment, a lot of electrical. So we're gonna come here and we're going to make a line that comes across right here. See how I did that? And goes down to the bottom. Because this is just going to be like a little section of the fire truck. And then we're going to make a line that comes up here. We're going to erase this because this area kind of dips down. It's like a segment. So we're going to erase that. So in this section, we're going to put some equipment. I'm going to make another line like this, like a little lip. I'm going to put a cone, a safety cone right here. That's just like a triangle. And we can make that orange. And then I'm gonna put just some mechanics. I'm gonna put a few lights, a few circles. Those will be lights. And these lights have chains that are kind of dangling from them. Okay. I'm gonna put like a box right here. That's gonna be kind of like an electric box that goes in here. Another circle and another chain. I am also going to be putting some circuit breaker areas right here. And then I'm gonna make a pattern of some triangles, things like that, maybe a few bolts. I'm making this up. It's kind of fun though. Some bolts, so this can be like a circuit breaker area. And up here is gonna be a few more little areas of mechanics. So I'm gonna make a little triangle, maybe make a line that goes this way, I don't know. It's kind of fun with art. I just use my imagination sometimes and let it take me. All right, so that's kind of, see how I just created this? This is gonna be like mechanics. So now we're gonna go to the back of our fire engine and complete it. All right, so I did, remember how I dipped this whole little technical part in the center of my fire truck? So this lip comes back up and we're gonna go all the way to the back. Now I'm gonna make my fire engine honestly, I thought this would be long enough. I'm going to make it a little longer. And then I'm going to, at the back of my fire truck, I'm going to tilt like that. Okay. And come down. And then come across. Now we're going to need another wheel and we're going to need some hoses and a ladder. We're going to finish our stripe. We're going to put a cone on the back, a safety cone on the back. So let's start with making a line that comes across from here, about right here from the bottom of this part all the way through here, okay? I think I might have some cat guests today. So if you see a little cat head come in my project today, because they're very curious about what I'm doing. All right, so this is gonna be a bottom of a ladder, okay? So I'm gonna come here and I'm gonna make another line that goes like this, right? Because these firefighters, they need ladders a lot. They need ladders to get up to people to help them. Like if there was a fire in a burning building, they need ladders. So to finish my ladder, what am I gonna do? I'm just gonna make lines, ladder lines. I go through my drawing like this. Kind of fun, pretty easy. It's gonna be a long ladder. Okay, now up here in this section, there's gonna be a couple big hoses that they're gonna use to attach maybe to some of these places to get water out. So I'm gonna make two long hoses. Long like this. Here's the attachment area. Okay, and that come across. There's one. I'm gonna make one right under it too. There's two. These are long hoses so they can attach to put out the fires. All right, and they're not perfect, and my art's not perfect. And nobody's art is perfect. Well, maybe some people, but not me. I just have fun with it. All right, so I'm gonna put something like this on the end. And in this ladder, I'm gonna put another hose. Okay, this is a hose that's kind of attached. This is gonna look kind of like a snake, okay? I'm gonna make this hose go through and make it a little thicker. It's gonna look like a snake almost. Not really a snake though. Okay, so that's a hose connected to the side. So let's go down to the bottom and finish this fire truck. All right, so we're gonna need to put another wheel well back here. I do want to, let's go to the end of the fire truck. Let's do a backlight. Okay, there's a nice backlight. There's a metal railing that comes from the top of the ladder. It's gonna come all the way down to the bottom. Okay. We're gonna put a cone right here. This will be another emergency cone that they can use if they need to stop traffic or stop some areas if they're going to rescue. Okay, so I'm gonna come on the side of the cone, and I'm going to make an area that looks like this. It's just gonna be a big, long square. In this square, we're gonna make a curve. Now, I kinda wanna make it about the same as this one. So it's gonna have to kinda be like as almost as big as the whole square. So one way to help your art look really cool is, and you get better at this, I tell you, I get better at this as I get older and practice, is you have to use your eye to estimate distance. So I'm looking at this. You can also use a ruler at this point to measure. Then, like, I have one handy, but if I'm like, okay. And as you can tell in the art class, I use rulers a lot. So that is a little over 1 inch. 1 1/4 inches. So I'm gonna come over here and say, this is 1.5 inches, almost 1.5 inches. So this one is actually a little wider than this one. So I'm gonna take it down a little bit. As I said, it doesn't have to be perfect, but we don't want a little teeny wheel on one side and then a big, huge wheel on the other side, because that's not gonna look right. Okay. I'm gonna make a curve above it. And And then I'm going to put a wheel, the back wheel in. So wheel, circle in the middle. Circle in the middle, little one, right? And then we do our bolts around the edge. All right, so there we go. Now, another thing we have to do to keep going on this project is we need that yellow stripe to continue through. So see how it ended like right here? Well, we're gonna pick that stripe back up and we're gonna take it through the rest of our fire truck. This really makes the fire truck stand out. This bright yellow, it's gonna go back here too. This bright yellow stripe. So now you can see the stripe goes through here, stops at our technical area, picks back up, and goes through the rest of my fire truck. Okay, so I'm gonna put a few more things and then I'm going to speed this up and show you how to color it in. I am gonna add, I forgot, I need one more bit light back here. Emergency light. A light at the top and back. Because if you ever see a fire truck, you can really see these lights going on and off, right? Blinking and blinking. I'm always like, when I see a fire truck coming down the street and I'm driving, I'm always trying to get out of the way for them. Give them room. I'm going to put kind of an area right here, a circle that has, this is kind of in a technical area where they can connect hoses. I'm gonna put an area right here to connect a hose. So to get the water out of the fire truck or anything that they need, they can connect hoses here. All right. I think one thing we do need to make this look good is I'm gonna make a line that goes through. This is gonna be my road line. And I am seeing that maybe I'm gonna make this tire a little lower to hit the bottom of that road. Okay. Now I think I have a pretty cool emergency vehicle in action. All right, so now what I'm gonna do is a time lapse, and then I'm gonna go through and I'm going to bring this to life with color, and then you can do the same. Before I do this, I wanna let you know, if you wanted to put something back here behind the fire truck, you could do buildings, you could do a burning building, you could do whatever you want to make this your own and original. I sure love when you guys make it your own. It makes it fun for you too. So if you have the time, you can go back here and design something. You could even turn this into like a real road. So here we go, time lapse. 1, 2, and 3. Boys and girls, I hope you had fun making your fire truck. This one takes a little bit of time, but it's super fun and well worth it. And thank you, firefighters and first responders and our military, for all you do for us. We appreciate you. Take care and have a great day.